Welcome to the College of Science and Engineering's Career Fair Preparation Presentation. From this video, you will learn how to prepare for the fair by researching employers, preparing your introduction when meeting employers, and learning how to follow up with employers after the fair. Each year, CSE hosts two large-scale career fairs, one in the fall and one in spring. It's important to understand that many companies recruit for interns and full-time positions in the fall. There are also opportunities to find positions during the spring semester, but you will increase your options by beginning your search now. Most career fairs in fall semester will have around 250 employers total over the 2 days of the fair. This year, we are in person at 3M Arena at Mirayuchi on Tuesday and Wednesday, September 20th and 21st. We have prep events to prepare you for the week before the fair on resume writing and interviewing strategies, and we'll also be hosting events. We are also offering a bonus virtual fair on Friday, October 7th. It's important to remember that you may not get a job or internship offer at the career fair, but you are creating an impression and a relationship with an employer, which could lead to job opportunities. Some of the benefits of attending the fair include gaining practice being in a professional setting and exploring different fields to discover positions, companies, and alternative career paths that you may not have considered. If you are actively searching for an internship, job, or co-op, the fair is a great opportunity to learn about employment opportunities and to be considered for moving on to next steps, such as an interview. Most employers report that they plan to follow up with at least one student, and the majority of employers plan to follow up with between 5 to more than 10 candidates. If you are not actively searching for an opportunity, you can take advantage of the fair by learning more about companies and positions, including what employers are seeking in applicants. You also have a chance to expand your professional network or begin building connections that will help once you are farther along in the search process. Networking can be thought of as simply meeting others and building relationships. It's estimated that between 70 and 80% of jobs in the United States are filled by word of mouth and direct referrals. This is also known as the hidden job market and is the primary way job seekers find positions once they are established in their careers. Again, the career fair is an excellent opportunity to meet employers and gain insight into the type of candidate they are looking for. Meeting face-to-face puts you at a competitive advantage and assists with showcasing your professionalism and interpersonal skills. Networking is a very common practice among professionals, and most are happy to talk with students and young professionals about their career and industry. To make the most of your time at the fair, plan on spending time preparing. The CSE Career Services website contains helpful information about events to attend, details about the fair, and frequently asked questions. The first thing you'll want to do to get ready for the career fair is to complete your Handshake profile. Visit handshake.umn.edu. Handshake is the university's job, co-op, and internship database. Students can use Handshake to apply for those positions and also to find and register for career events and to research employers. As a student at the University of Minnesota, you are able to log into Handshake with your U of M username and password. Go to the My Profile section and complete as much of your profile as possible, including your major and degree program. As long as your privacy settings are set to be public, employers can view your profile. The more information you provide, the better. You can also upload your resume to the My Documents section. Once you do this for the first time, CSE Career Services will automatically review your resume and approve it for applying to positions. Update your profile and upload your resume as soon as possible. The Career Center receives many resumes just before the fair and will need time to look them over for approval. Employers typically have interviews shortly after the fair, and you will need an approved resume in Handshake in order to apply. Go to the Events tab in Handshake and search for the College of Science and Engineering. Registration for the career fair is recommended but not required. If you do register for the career fair, you will be able to receive important announcements and details related to the career fair. On the main page of the fair, you will be able to see all employers that are listed here. You may wish to use the filters to view employers who are hiring for your major, or employers who are in a specific industry, or a particular location, and many other criteria. Plan on spending time before the fair researching employers to learn exactly which companies you will want to connect with at the fair. You may see job titles or positions listed on the company profile. We recommend searching the company name or position title in the job section of Handshake to see the position descriptions that may not be linked on the Career Fair page. You can also follow companies to be added to a filtered list and get notifications about updates on that company. Apply for positions now. Do not wait until the career fair. On-campus interviews happen after the fair, and there's often a quick turnaround time for some companies. You'll want to make sure your resume is updated before the fair. Career Services has information here, including a resume guide, examples, and templates you can copy and customize. If you have time before the fair, schedule an appointment with a career counselor for a resume review, or plan on attending drop-ins for a 10-minute quick review. You can also send your resume to csecareer@umn.edu. On September 19th, Career Services will have a virtual resume marathon where you are able to have your resume reviewed by an employer. More information on how to sign up is included later in this presentation. When you're connecting with a professional in person, such as at a career fair, a company information session, or a conference, it's important to prepare a quick introduction, also known as an elevator pitch, to introduce yourself and outline your career goals, your skills, and your interests. Think about using the present, past, future model when shaping your introduction. You might share your name, your year in school, and your major and degree program. You can mention any skills and experiences you have had that relate to your professional goals, and then refer to some highlights from your resume. You can then articulate why you want to meet with them and mention why the company is of interest to you. Lastly, ask a question related to the type of candidates they are seeking or a particular internship, job, or co-op you want to learn more about. It helps to remember that this is simply a conversation starter. You do not need to memorize and rehearse word for word what you'll say. Just have some general ideas in mind and plan on practicing with a friend or family member beforehand. Wearing appropriate attire at the fair can increase your confidence and capture the attention of recruiters. Dress in a way that is authentic to how you'd like to be viewed in the workplace. For many, that means a suit, jacket, a buttoned-up shirt and a tie, or a blouse and dress pants or skirt. It's best to avoid t-shirts, sweatshirts, and more casual options. You can view some ideas on the CSE Career Pinterest page. In the past, students who have attended the fair have mentioned that future attendees should wear comfortable shoes as there may be a lot of walking. If you are in need of professional clothing, CSE has partnered with an organization called Ready for Success to provide professional clothing at no cost to you. Appointments are limited and based on financial need. It is recommended that you go to this website to complete their online application as soon as possible. If you are approved for a clothing appointment, we will provide you with instructions on the next steps in the process. Appointments are set up in advance and will require that you travel to the organization. It's near campus and accessible via public transit. Appointments are between 1 and 2 hours in length and include at least one suit as well as accessories, pending availability. The University of Minnesota is also offering transportation to the JCPenney suit-up event on Sunday, September 18th. This will take place at the Rosedale Mall and offers price deductions between 30 and 50% for professional clothing. Bus transportation will be provided to and from Lilly Plaza on the East Bank outside of Northrop. Buses will leave approximately every 20 minutes starting at 2:50 p.m. To make the most of your time on the day of the fair, try to arrive early in order to make sure you have time to speak with the busiest employers. Prioritize companies you want to visit. When you arrive at the fair, you will have access to a map which will show where employer booths are located. Handshake has an app which you can also use on the day of the fair to view employers of interest. However, it's recommended that you do the majority of your employer research on a web browser before the fair, as we have noted that the employer filters do not work reliably on Android devices. You want to meet with your top choices early in the day, and if you are nervous, it might help to meet with an employer who is not among your top choices first in order to practice your introduction and calm your nerves. Remember to keep an open mind, as your current fourth choice company may become your first choice after you've had a chance to talk with them and learn more about them. When you approach an employer, offer a confident greeting, such as a handshake, make eye contact, smile, and use your introduction to introduce yourself. Offer your resume to the employer and tell them about yourself, beginning with your introduction or elevator pitch. Be polite, honest, and enthusiastic. Speak slowly, clearly, and concretely. Most importantly, relax and be yourself. Be engaged in your conversations with employers and discuss your qualifications and interest in their company. Ask them about their hiring process and how you can be considered for opportunities. Ask employers about setting up an informational interview to learn more about their company and opportunities they may have. You may also want to look at the Major and Career Exploration Guide on the CSE Career website to learn more about setting up an informational interview. If an employer directs you to apply online, don't be discouraged. Many employers don't take paper resumes at the career fair, but it is important that you make an impression at the booth. Some employers will note if you visit the booth and later verify that you applied online. Before you leave, ask for a business card and their preferred method of follow-up and thank them for their time. After the fair, be sure to follow up with employers if you're interested in continuing the conversation. Send them an email or a LinkedIn message reminding them of where you met and mention something unique about your conversation. Express appreciation for their information and what they shared for their time. If you are job searching, reiterate your interest, restate your qualifications, and let them know that you have applied for a position with the company. If you're at the career fair to network, ask to set up an informational interview. Apply for positions that you learned about, follow the company on LinkedIn, and consider connecting with the recruiters that you met. Keep in touch after the fair and follow up within a week or two to inquire about their hiring timeline. You should also use the time after the fair to prepare for interviews and consider attending employer information sessions on campus. Many employers do want to connect with students outside of the career fair as well, and will be hosting information sessions. In order to find relevant sessions for CSE students, go to the Events tab in Handshake, then use the filters to find Information Sessions and College of Science and Engineering. Here are some of the virtual events that we have to help you prepare for the fair. For quick career questions and resume reviews that can be completed in 10 minutes or less, attend our virtual drop-in sessions. Practice Interview Day on Friday, September 16th, and Resume Marathon on Monday, September 19th will put you in touch with employers who will conduct practice interviews and give you feedback, or review your resume to ensure you are ready for the fair. Sign up in Handshake under the Jobs tab and search for Practice Interview Day or Resume Marathon. Then go through the steps required to sign up. Here are additional workshops to check out, including interactive interviewing on Monday, September 12th, a live career fair prep session on Tuesday, September 13th, a What's Up Co-op session to learn all about engineering co-op program on Wednesday, September 14th, a resume writing presentation on Thursday, September 15th, and two virtual international student career fair prep presentations, one on Friday, September 16th, and the other on Monday, September 19th. We encourage you to connect with a career counselor to start planning. Even if you are discussing steps that will take place in the distant future, beginning to plan now and being aware of the career planning process early on will help you be better prepared when you need to take action. Thanks for watching, and good luck at the fair.